Hi all, Chunky Prepper here. I would like to take this opportunity to welcome you all to my 24-hour British Military Ration Review. The Ration Packs are also known as Operation Ration Packs, or ORPs for short. I have all 20 menus from boxes A and B. The production date for box A is July 2017, and the production date for box B is June 2017. The best before date will be within a 3-year time period from the production date, but as most of us know, they will last several years after this date, as long as they are kept in the correct conditions. Just remember to use your senses. If it looks okay, if it smells okay, and then it tastes okay, then it must be okay. I will review the menus in order from 1 to 20. However, in between doing so, I will also review military rations from other countries like the US, Russia, France, Poland, and Canada. I have already reviewed menu 1, that's if you can call what I did a review. It's basically me eating my dinner whilst I was camping out in the woods. So with all that said, I hope you like my first review, menu number 1, which is a vegetarian meal. Huh? Let's get on with it, I say. So this is box number 1. First out the bat, or out the box should I say, is the accessory bag, which you have your teas, coffees, sugars, creamers, chewing gum and spork. Next we have tissue, toilet tissue, tissue for your nose. We have a fruit flavoured energy drink powder, orange. We have another drink, which is a tropical flavoured drink powder with sugar and sweeteners. And we have another drink, which is a tutti frutti flavoured drink. We have a fruit flavoured energy drink powder, which is raspberry. We're still going with the drinks, and we have a hot chocolate drink, mint flavour. We have a oatmeal block, smooth peanut bar, a bag of roasted and salted peanuts, cheddar cheese flavoured spread, one of the sesame seed bars. We have a fruit explosion, which is a mixed fruit puree. It's got an orange top, orange is orange cap, apple and peach. We have a bottle of hot original pepper sauce, which is hot diggity dog. We have plain rice. We have a chickpea curry. Chickpeas with onion and potato in a spicy curry. Looking forward to that one. We have a bean and pasta salad. I've actually had that before. I quite like that, to be fair. And this is my breakfast, which is natural muesli with milk. And lastly, for dessert, I have a mince pie slice. That's it, apart from the menu card. And it has menus 1 to 5, and then 6 to 10. And the last thing it has in there is feedback and prize draw entry form. You can actually, well, if you was in the army, you'll do this. You wouldn't do this as a civilian. But they would like you to fill that out and send it back and tell them what you thought of it and all that lot. And you could end up winning a competition. It is possible that if you do, as a civilian, fill this in and send it off to the MOD, you might get a knock on your door. So I wouldn't do it. Just throw that in the bin, discard of it. But that's it, that's everything in that box. What we do have left though is the accessory pack, and we'll go through that now. We have our windproof, possibly waterproof matches, I think they're just windproof matches. We have a white sugar, we have an English breakfast tea, we have a Thai food tea, we have a Nescafe original coffee. I normally get these, but in 3-in-1, which comes with sugar and creamer. We have some chewing gum, strong mint. We have another sugar. We have some purifying tablets. We have 6 of those. And then we have the wipes. Alcohol-free antibacterial wipes. We have 2 of those. We have another sugar. We have some more chewing gum. And this is white spearmint. And we have some white peppermint chewing gum. We have a Rombots instant coffee. Rum belts. We have a creamer, Beyond the Beaten Track. We have another sugar. And 3 more creamers. They feel soft, so they might be all right. We will soon find out. And we have, the spork. Quite durable. So what we're going to have for breakfast is the natural muesli with milk, the oatmeal block, fruit explosion. The drink we're going to have is the raspberry fruit flavoured energy drink. And we're going to have that with a lovely cup of English breakfast tea. Sugar, creamer, and some chewing gum to finish it off with. As Steve, 1989 MRE Info would say, let's get this on the tree. Nice. So let's start with the muesli. Doesn't have a tear notch, you could probably tear it down that way. Oak's quite tough. Let's cut open with a knife. Smells okay. Looks okay. So you know what they say. It smells okay, looks okay, and then finally tastes okay, then it must be okay. So there's the natural muesli with milk. It calls for 100 milliliters of water. You could, if you wanted to, add hot water. I prefer to use cold water. So, let's stir. Let's leave that to let it do its thing. Let's make tea. Like I said, we're going to use the English breakfast tea. That's annoying. Stuck to it. You have to be careful with that. There's the English breakfast tea. I'm going to just let that soak just there. I don't want that to get lost in there because it's split. Sugar. I have 2 of those. We'll hold off on the creamer for a little while. I need to taste the creamer just to make sure it's okay, but I'm going to hold off on that. I'm going to have the raspberry drink. Whoa, that's potent. So I'm going to leave that for a little while. Let's get the oat block out. Smells all right, looks all right, and I'm sure it will taste okay. Let's have a little look at the flute explosion. Give it a little shake first. Oh, it's going everywhere. Tasty. That's quite tasty actually, that's quite nice and refreshing. Take your tea bag, put it on your spoon, wrap the string around and give it a little squeeze to get the last remaining tea out of there. Right, let's try this creamer. I think the creamer is going to be okay, but you can never tell. Let's make sure we taste it and not snort it. Tastes alright, cream. It's actually got a nice strong cream flavour. Two lots of creamer, job done. Get the old shovel back again. I've got a feeling two sugars in that amount of tea is not going to be enough, but hey yo. If not, there we go. English breakfast tea. I do. Personally, I'd rather it had a little bit more sugar in it. Let's try the raspberry flute flavoured energy drink. So yes, the raspberry one. Smells nice. Looks okay. Tastes quite nice. Quite like that actually. This don't look too bad. It's getting a little bit stodgy, but it's alright, a little bit more water. I do like a loose muesli rather than a porridgey type muesli. Not that I have muesli that often. So that's roughly about how I'd like it. Let's have a smell first. Smells alright. Looks alright. So if it looks alright, smells okay. Tastes okay. But yeah, look. Tasty. It's actually a bit plain without some sort of sweetener. Let's try that. You know, I'm not 100% sure whether I like it. It's okay, there's nothing wrong with it. It just feels it misses something. Where are them peanuts? Let's try some of these roasted and salted peanuts. Oh, they smell nice. They look all right and all. So let's mix it up a bit. Let's just put a sprinkle of peanuts in there. A little bit more sugar might help. That does work, that's a lot better. Maybe a little bit more sugar. I can definitely taste the salt from the peanuts. Oh, that's much better. Oh yeah, definitely. But if I was to be honest, I prefer the all-day breakfast. If I had some honey, that would be really, really nice. Right, oatmeal biscuit. Well, that's nice and soft. Well, I like that. Let's do what us Brits do best, and that's dunk the biscuit in the tea. Does that make a difference? It does. It's quite tasty, that was. That was the best bit of the breakfast, I think. Let's try some more of this fruit explosion. Right, let's polish this off. Tell you what, certainly feeling. I'm actually struggling to eat this. There you go. Tea. I'll come back to that in a minute.
and struggling. Tea done. Raspberry flavoured drink done. Oatmeal done. Tea was done. Just chewing gum left. We get two bits. Oh, definitely spearmint, that's for sure. Well, that's it. For breakfast. And for lunch, we're going to have the bean and pasta salad. The peanuts, cheddar cheese flavoured spread. Drinks wise, we're going to have the tropical flavoured drink powder. And we're going to have both coffees at the same time. We're going to have the Nescafe and the Rombelts. I'm going to need at least two, maybe three sugars for this. I've got some creamers. The last two were okay, so I'm guessing these two will be fine. Some alcohol-free antibacterial wipes to wipe my hands before I have my dinner. Or should I say lunch. And to finish it off, I've got two strong mints. Right, let's start with the bean and pasta salad. I'm going to make the coffee. Using the Rombelts coffee as well as the Nescafe coffee. I'll try first with two sugars and the creamers. Again, I will try these beforehand. Yep, fine. Doesn't look too bad. Right, let's go straight to the tropical fruit drink. Right, let's get the peanuts out. This is the second packet I've opened today. I'm going to try that hot diggity dog on the pasta just to see if I need it as well as the cheese sauce, so I'm going to leave that there. Right, the pasta's been warmed up. It's actually hot. I have kneaded a little bit, but I don't like to knead it too much because it breaks down the contents inside and it looks mushy. Ooh. I'm surprised at the look of that. It looks quite nice. Smells nice. I don't know if you can see inside there. Let's pour it out. Let's have a little look, see. No salt or pepper in the British Army ration packs. I don't think I've ever come across salt and pepper in them. Might have done a few years back. Doesn't look too bad. I think that's a great huge butter bean. Not 100% sure. You definitely got some kidney beans or red beans. Can't see anything else. Can't see any chopped onions or anything like that. But I'm sure they're in there in the pasta sauce. But no, don't look too bad. But first, let's go all hygiene, okay? Let's clear our hands if it isn't too late already with the wipe, which is quite a large wipe in the British Army ration packs. Tough enough, stretches out a bit. Certainly moist. Right, there we go, let's carry on. Let's try a bit of this bean pasta sauce. Right, let's have a go. Let's have a bite, as they say. That's actually quite nice just on its own. Don't know if you can see it. As my mate Trevor Kamikaze would say, that is a badge of honour. Let's try it with a few extra kidney beans. For a vegetarian meal, that's quite nice. I'm going to try a bit of sauce first. This still doesn't make sense to me, but I'll just put some down at the front. Anyway, let's try it. Let's have another go. With a bit of cheese. Not too much pasta. Needs mixing in because you get that cheddar cheese spread is quite strong. You don't mix it in and you get a big dollop of it on the spoon, which I think I've done again there. All you get is cheddar cheese, so I think there's a little bit in here somewhere. Let's try that. Yeah, that does work. I actually quite like that with the cheddar cheese. Right, let's try it with the Diggity Dog hot sauce. I'm a great fan of Tabasco sauce, especially the chipotle. I do like that. Let's put it somewhere else and not... Oh, it is runny. I've got a feeling that's going to be hot. Let's try it where it's not mixed in. Yeah, it's hot. Ooh. Yep, that's hot on the tongue, not on the throat, just the tongue. So it ain't too bad, so it ain't going to last long. Let's add a little bit more and mix it in just over here. But it is hot. I think that's similar to Tabasco, standard Tabasco heat wise. The chipotle one's a little bit milder, and it's got a lovely flavour to it. Right. So that is with cheese and hot diggity dog sauce, should I say. Let's eat a part of it what doesn't have any hot sauce or cheese. Use that as a palate cleanser, if possible. I can definitely taste the cheese now. Couldn't taste that before because of the hot sauce. It's got a nice little warm flavour, as in spicy warm. You know what? I'm going to eat the whole lot with some additional cheese. It actually worked. I was surprised that the cheese worked. Probably a bit too much cheese now. Never bloody happy, am I? And try some peanuts separately. I'm going to actually try and crush a few of these up if I can without losing too many. And we're back. Now, I just lost video. Anyway, let me eat this with the peanuts in. Okay. It does make a difference. It's not too bad actually. It's improved it. Now you've got the texture there. Quite nice. I think the only way I can improve that any more would be to add meat. Sorry. Peanuts anyone? I've got tons of them now. That wasn't too bad. Let's have some coffee with a few floaters on them. They're not too bad. Let's have the tropical flavour drink. Oh, that tastes so much better now. My tongue's not burning anymore. Right, we've had breakfast. We've had lunch. Next is dinner. And for our dinner, we're going to have a chickpea curry. So looking forward to this, with plain rice. For afters, we're going to have a mince pie slice. We're going to have, snack wise, we're going to have the sesame seed bar. Somehow, if we can, we're going to put the smooth peanut butter in there. And we're going to have a little bit more of the hot original pepper sauce, which is the hot diggity dog sauce. Drinks wise, we're going to have an orange energy drink. And the hot drink we're going to have is a hot chocolate drink, mint flavour. The plain rice and the chicken curry need to be heated up, so I'm going to use my Swedish cook set. So I'm going to do the drinks. I'm going to do the orange fruit flavoured energy drink. Do the hot chocolate drink, mint flavoured. There's quite a lot of powder in there, as you can see. The mains are going to take a little bit longer. So let's start with the alcohol-free antibacterial wipe. Let's take out the dentist bar, I mean the sesame seed bar. Let's try a bit. Goodbye, teeth. They are good. Let's have some of this orange energy drink. Yeah, it definitely tastes better while it smells. Let's try the hot chocolate mint flavoured. I had this only, well, 2 nights ago, so I know it's nice. That is a nice hot chocolate there. Anyway, let's go to the mains. The mains are hot. Yep, they're hot. Oh, we've got rice flying around everywhere. Let's put it at one side. Right, let's get the chickpea curry. It's chickpeas with onion and potato in a spicy curry sauce. Yeah, there's quite a lot of it. I'm not going to eat all this. He says with a smile on his face. There you go, that's a chickpea curry with plain rice. It's actually really, really nice. I'll try the rice on its own, but it just looks dry. Yeah, definitely dry. You won't want to eat much of that on its own. So let's mix some over here. That is so much better. Not just for the rice, but for the chickpea curry as well. gives it that little bit of different texture in there. Chickpeas are quite nice. I'm going to add some hot sauce to this bit over here, mix that in, just to try it, just to see if it does anything to it, improves it in any way, shape or form, apart from burning my mouth again. Oh, I can smell it. That's definitely improved it, but that stuff is quite warm. I don't know why I'm going to do this, but I'm going to do it anyway. Try some peanut butter there somewhere. I think I'm going to just dollop some out here. Let's try it. You know what? That works. Oh my. That actually does really work. That's really, really nice with peanut butter. Let's see if I can mix some of the hot sauce from what I mixed earlier into the peanut butter one. Looks like a right dog's dinner, doesn't it? It tastes nice, eh? Well, it did do. That does taste really, really good. That's good. I don't really want to eat all this, but I'm not going to waste this. This is just too good for that, actually. Let's see what I can do. I'm not called chunky for nothing, you know. Done. So the mince pie has been warmed up. Time to eat it. Let's have a look-see. Oh, that smells Christmassy, that does. Don't need that. It's not hot, that's warm. Let's see if it'll break. I've got a feeling it'll just bend. Yeah, look. It's very pliable while they're warm. Well, similar, I never had this before, I don't think. Got loads of mincemeat, which is a fruit, not the mince what you would mince from meat like beef or pork. I think that puts a lot of people off. When you say a mince pie, they think it's like beef mince when it's not. It's a fruit mince of all sorts. Plenty of it. Oh, that's lovely. Mmm. Very sweet. But warming them up does make a difference. That's quite tasty. It's borderline sickly though, as in sweet. But I do like it. Go straight to the mint. This is a peppermint chewing gum this time. Two again. That's better. So what do I think to menu one of the 24-hour British Army ration? If I was to be honest, it wasn't that bad. I quite liked it. I certainly liked that chickpea curry. The bean and pasta sauce was okay. The only thing I didn't really take to was the muesli. Putting peanuts in there made a difference. If I could have crushed them like I did when I put them in the pasta, then I think that would have been better. Leaving them whole is a bit too chunky, even for me. The mince pie was nice, but a bit sweet in the end. The oatmeal block was nice. I actually quite enjoyed that. That was a lot softer than I actually thought. Without crackers or a plain bit of bread, I just don't see the point of the peanut butter and cheese. However, in both occasions of using like the cheese and the peanut butter in the main meals, it did make a difference and it was quite nice. The peanut butter made a massive difference in that chickpea curry. I think that's why I probably would give it a 7 rather than a 6, but yeah. Can you do that?
Yeah, of course you can.
The mint flavour hot chocolate drink powder, oh that was lovely, that's just to die for, that stuff. That's nice, creamy, thicky, you know, chocolatey and very minty. So yeah, let's give it a rating. Breakfast wise, out of 10, I think it might have to stay around a 4-5 mark. If it had honey, that would bump it up to probably 6. The lunch, which was the bean and pasta sauce, that was okay. I quite like those big beans, whether they're butter beans or broad beans, I'm not too sure, but that was quite nice, it had some flavour. Rating wise for that, probably a 6 at a push. And for the chickpea curry and rice, if I rated the rice, the rice would be like a 3 or 4 because it's dry and nothing there. But a chickpea curry, that was quite nice. I would probably give that a 6, maybe 7, I think. Overall, out of 10, 5, maybe 5.5. If I had to quickly run into the mess hall or whatever you want to call it, and they had boxes 1 to 10 sitting on the worktop, I think I would avoid number 1 and go for something else, but still not that bad. But yes, anyway, that was my review of the menu number 1 from the 24-hour British Army rations. Join me next time for menu number 2. Thanks for watching.